So next, while coming this substructure and superstructure, in the we have two types of structure. So when you are going to study geotechnical engineering, we have to study substructure. So when you are going to study about this structure, that we call as a superstructure. So what is the reason to we have to study? So we are not going to study the structural people. So we are completely geotechnical people. So why we need to study this substructure and superstructure? What is the reason? So I will tell you what is the reason to study this substructure and superstructure. Suppose if you are going to design any structure, whether it is buildings or bridges or dams or foundation, otherwise residential buildings or commercial buildings. So based on the giving the loads, that we can classify as the structure is below ground level. So we have to draw the based on the df by b ratio, and df by b less than 1, that we call as a shallow foundation. Df by b greater than 1, that we call as a deep foundation. So when you are going to study the geotechnical engineering and foundation engineering, why they are introducing the civil engineering as a one subject? So I'll tell you very clearly. So in the geotechnical people, they have to study very clearly. When you are going to take the any structure, whether if it any soil profile, suppose if you take it in Dundigal, otherwise Kompally, otherwise Dulapalli. So in India, entire India, so around 13 lakhs of black and soil is occupied. So 13 lakhs of land is occupied by the black and soil only. So in these regions, so in the, suppose when you are going to design, so I am going to design the structure. So I am going to design the one beach. So in the particular location, so first we have to study soil investigation report. In the soil investigation report is nothing but recognized survey, preliminary survey, and as detailed surveys. So we have to study the surveys. So after conducting the surveys, so then we go for exploration. So exploration is not exploration, subsurface exploration. So in the subsurface exploration is nothing but, so we have to excavate some pits. So excavating the pits, trial pits. So in this geotechnical engineering, we have to study below the ground level only. So in the below the ground level, so what is going on that? So in the below the ground level, we have 20, just now we have discussed 22 groups of soil. So in the 22 groups of soil, so when you are going to using the design of construction purpose, so whether it is suitable or not. So sometimes we have organic soil and inorganic soils, we have different types of soils are available. So in this geotechnical engineering, so suppose if you are taking the clay, so if you take it in silt, next if you take it sand, so these three materials which is useful for foundation purpose or not. Suppose if you are taking the clay and silt and sand, and the sand we go for is construction material, and silt also we are using that construction material, and the clay also we are going to use the construction materials. Suppose in these materials, when you are going to study the materials, these are the, suppose just now this is the clay soil that we have discussed today, clay. So clay is nothing but 0.002 mm particle size of the soil is nothing. When you are going to study clay, the less than 0.002 mm soil, that we call as a clay. So when you are going to use this clay in foundation material, so what will happen? So in the clay is nothing but black modern soil. So BC soil. So what is the meaning by BC soil? It is highly high swelling and sinkage. So after what will happen after swelling or sinkage the soil? What will happen? The structure will be closely settled down. So the structure slowly settled down. So what will happen? So when you are going to study settlement of the foundation or settlement of the soil, so what will happen? So we have, when you are going to due to this swelling and sinkage, the structure will be settlement. So the settlements also we have to study. The settlements also they can classify as three settlements. primary settlements, initially settlements and secondary settlements. Otherwise, primary consolidation, initial consolidation and secondary consolidation. That we discuss, that we study later. So, in the BC soil is nothing but high swelling and shrinkage. Due to these reasons, the structure of the superstructure or substructure will be happen some causes. So, due to this swelling and shrinkage, the structure will be cause some failures. So, that failures we have some different types: shear failure, tow failure, local failure, and general failures. So, in this clay, when you are going to discuss the clay, so when we are, suppose if you are at this clay, so taking 100 grams of soil and adding 10 ml of water to this soil, so what will happen to the structure? So when you are adding this 10 ml of water, it will absorb entire amount of water. It will absorb, if you take it silt, it will absorb 70%. Suppose if you take it in clay, it will absorb 100%. So if you take it sand, so it will absorb 20% of the water. If you take it in boulders, if you take it in aggregates, so the boulders after completion of sand, so we have next aggregates, it won't absorb, zero. Next boulders, so it is also 0% absorption. So that is the reason when you are going to study clay soils, so we have some important topic is we have to discuss. That important topic is nothing but permeability. So what do you mean by permeability? So what is the reason? So why we have to study this permeability in it? So permeability, it can be denoted by K and the unit is meter per second or sometimes centimeter per second. So what is the necessity for studying the permeability? So permeability is nothing but the flow of water enter into this soil. Suppose if you take it, this is a one soil structure, I am telling soil structure. So that is the reason I will tell you here one more important point, soil mechanics. So I will explain one more important topic on soil mechanics. So this is the mechanics is nothing but the flow of water enter into this. Suppose if it is take it as a soil structure, so this is a soil material. So mechanics nothing but the application of losses of forces. So these forces acting on soil. Okay, so this is the material, is a soil. These forces acting on the this particular soil are called as a soil mechanics. Suppose these soil mechanics, okay, suppose the this combination soil and mechanics, suppose the water enter into this structure, what will happen the structure? So once after entering the soil, water enter into the soil, okay, it will create some problems, quicksand condition, boiling condition or kick condition. So the flow of water enter into the soil, that we call as a permeability. So the loss of application of forces acting on the soil, that we call as soil mechanics. So the permeability is nothing but the flow of water enter into the soil, that we call as a permeability. So in this regard, permeability is nothing but the flow of water enter into the soil, that we call as a permeability. So suppose we have some different types of soils. So this is the flow enter into the soil. Suppose I am taking fine grain soils. So F soils. So another one is coarse grain soils. So we have two types of soils. Okay, fine grain soils and coarse grain soils. So this is when we are going to discuss this topic, the fine grain soils. So we have fine grain soils. How we are going to identify these fine grain soils? I'll tell you. The fine grain soils nothing but, so these are the size of the 75 microns. Okay. So this size is 4.5 25 mm, 75 microns, that we call as a fine grain soils. Otherwise, the more than 50% of soil passing through the 425 or 75 microns, that we call as a fine grain soils. The more than 50% of the soil is retained, either 425 microns or 425 mm or 75 micron, that we call as a coarse grain soils. So how we are going to classify the soil? Soil is nothing but naturally occurring consolidation. Now we are telling. So how we are going to identify the fine grain soils? How we are going to identify the coarseness? What are the materials comes under these fine grain soils? What are the materials comes under these coarse grain soils? Suppose in the fine grain soils is nothing but, I'll tell you very clearly, please remember. So fine grain soils is nothing but clay and silt. So if you touch it, suppose if you take it this chalk piece powder, okay, so crumbled it, okay, twist it. So if you observe with the help of your eyes, so with the help of naked eyes also, if you observe with the help of ears, suppose if you are rubbing here with the help of your two fingers, if you are getting any sound, that we call it as a coarse grain soils. If you are not getting any sound, that we call it as a fine grain soil. If you take it in clay, so you can't get any sound. If you take it silt, you can't get any sound. So based on these physical properties, so we can classify it as a fine grain soil. Comes under clay and silt is comes under this fine grain soil. Suppose if you are taking coarse grain soils, so suppose if you take in the coarse grain soils, so if you touch it, you will get some different types of physical physical appearance. So suppose if you take it in sand, so you will get some different types of sound. So aggregates, that you can tell, this is called a coarse grain soils, and boulders, so next rocks material and all. So these all three comes under this coarse grain soils and fine grain soils. So in these, while finding the permeability of the soil, so for K we are telling K is nothing but permeability of soil, the flow of water enter into the soil. So suppose I am taking this fine grain soil and coarse grain soil. In the how we are going to find the permeability of coarse grain soils, how we are going to find the permeability of fine grain soils. So what are the methods? So we are going to, which type of methods we are going to adopt? So suppose if you are taking this coarse grain soil and fine grain soil, and very very shortcut method. Suppose if you are taking fine grain soils, so directly we go for falling head method. So fine grain soil and next coarse grain soil. So then we go for variable head methods. So these two methods we are going to find the permeability of clay soil and permeability of coarse grain soils and fine grain soils and coarse grain soils. So here falling head method and variable head method. So see, if you take fine grain soils, this comes under this clay, and silt, these two materials comes under this fine grain soils. So here coarse grain soils, we have to discuss aggregates and the sand, next boulders, next rocks, all these materials comes under this coarse grain soil. Suppose if you want to find the K value of fine grain soils, K value of coarse grain soils. So just now we have discussed in clay and silt, if we observe total amount of water in the aggregates and boulders and rock materials and sand, you won't observe. So that's why the K values greater than coarse grain soils. So when compared to fine grain soils, coarse grain soil, the permeability is very less. So when you compare to coarse grain soils, the permeability of fine grain soils is more high. Why? What is the reason? I'll tell you. For example, one reason. So in the fine grain soil, just now the flow of water enter into the soil. it will all, if you take in clay and silt is a very fine material, just know the, with the help of physical properties also we can identify, with the help of NACAD also we can identify the soil is clay and the soil is silt. So when you are entering into this particular suppose if you are taking 100 ml of water, pour into this silt and pour into the clay, it will absorb total amount of water. Here it will absorb 97%, it will absorb more than 90%. So that is the reason here all the soils, all the materials, there is no impermeable material in the soil. So thank you to all.